We have a lot going on in this environment, not only in maternal health, but also in the maternal child transition, gynecology, contraception, urogynecology, GYN oncology, all different areas of the breadth of OB-GYN. Part of what I do with the residents is help them get their resident research projects, their scholarly activities going. We have a lot of mentorship and resources that will help them complete their projects in the time that they're allotted. We start halfway through the first year where we start having them think about their questions and their topics that they would like to accomplish, and then hook up with a faculty member so that they're able to really dive into the question they want to ask. Then through the course of their second year and third year, there are several scheduled meetings with a group of mentors and advisors who can really help them get their projects accomplished, approved, and really get it in the best shape possible to present at research day, which is at the end of third year. And what I often tell the residents is that their projects shouldn't die on research day. They should continue on, and actually they should present them at meetings or get them published through the course of their chief year. One of the goals that we have in doing a scholarly activity in the first place is really to help residents understand the literature and understand advances in health that they're going to be reading about. Because if you can do some research and understand the research methodology better, it'll make you a better consumer of that research. And when residents get into practice after they graduate, they'll need to understand that things that are coming out in the literature may impact the way they practice medicine and may change from things that they did when they were in residency.